Are you still downloading all your Facebook leads from Facebook lead ads manually, or have you integrated Facebook lead ads with your CRM system already seamless? If not, then keep watching this video. I will explain you exactly how you can automate it completely to instantly transfer any lead from Facebook lead ad into your own CRM system. Hey, my name is Manuel and I'm the founder of Techflow.AI and we love automation. First, what is a CRM system? A CRM system, for those who don't know yet, is a customer relation management system. And that usually helps you to keep everything organized, all informations in one place that you have of one customer to make greater decisions of cycling leads throughout a sales cycle. So it's very important. And if you don't have one yet, you should create your own one. Even if it's just a simple sheet or something like that, keeping records of your customers and your relations is really important. So in that case, we are going to look at how to transfer Facebook lead ads into your CRM system. We have a very simple Google Sheet only as an example, but you can literally connect it to any CRM system that you're using, like Pipedrive or HubSpot or Soho CRM or Espo CRM or Capsule CRM or whatever CRM system you're using. There are tons of them out there. So just pick yours or choose yours from the list and then connected to it. The most important thing, or the crucial thing that people struggle with, is actually setting up the Facebook lead ads module within Make. So let's jump right into it and I will show you the exact steps that you need to take in order to set it up by creating a form, testing it, mapping the data accordingly into your CRM system, and then turning on the automation so it runs on autopilot. All right, let's jump into it. First, you will have to create a new scenario and then search for Facebook lead ads. It contains a couple of modules here, the new lead, watch leads, get lead details, and get a form, unsubscribe a webhook, and list leads module. We need the new lead one. This is marked with an instant tag. That means it will work in real time. Whenever a new lead comes in, this automation will fire and send it to your CRM system. So you'll have it in real time and you can do further actions with it. For example, also add it to your autoresponder. So the lead also gets an email and it's not like running into the dark, just waiting for a couple of hours until you've processed it manually. So that's very helpful. Always look out for this instant batch if you want to have something happening in real time. Then to set up this module, we click on it and we need to create a new webhook. Then within that webhook, you have to establish your Facebook connection. If you haven't done it yet, press on the add button and then add your own Facebook connection. You can give it a name, whatever you want to, or keep the default one, and then select the page that you want to get the leads from. In our case, I will choose this one, and then it will show you all the available forms. Right now, we just have a test lead form, but you can also leave it empty. If you leave it empty, it will get the leads from all forms that you have connected to this page, even the forms that you will create in the future. So I suggest keeping it open unless you have thousands of different forms and you just want to watch the leads of one, but it's usually easier to set it up like this and then distribute the leads later on based on the form that they opted into. So I will leave it open for now, and then you can select the fields that you want to be sent to the rest of the scenario. So you have IDs, add ID, add name, add set ID, and blah, blah, blah. So a lot of different things here, and you don't have to check anything here. If you don't check anything, it will send just all available fields. If you select something, if you only need specific details out, you can of course pre-select something. I will leave it open for now because I don't want to limit the output by any means. All right. So this is set up now and I will unlink this for a second. And now it is about getting actual data into the system. So we know what to expect and how we can map it to our CRM system. This is a little bit tricky. I will put all links required for this into the description of this video. So make sure to read it down below. On Facebook, you need to get into business.facebook.com and then to latest instant forms. You can also find it by clicking on all tools and then searching for forms in this bar at the top. It might look slightly different on your end what time you're watching this video, but I'm pretty sure you will find it from the search. So instant forms, and then you will land over here. If you don't have a form yet, create a new form. If you already have a form, you can skip this part. Then create a new form, give it a name, test form, choose the form type, give it an intro. For testing purposes, I use the image from your ad, so I don't have to upload any image yet. Here is the ad line, details. This is not relevant for the testing part. And then for questions, I can add any kind of custom question at the top. It can be multiple choice, can be short answer, conditional, or appointment request. In that case, I'll just use like short answer. What is your favorite fruit? And then also the pre-filled questions, we'll use this to send you the lead magnet, whatever. So just put whatever you need to do here, fill it out, email, full name. And then for privacies, you need to add a link here. So HTTPS, Techflow.AI, and privacy policy. This will look like this in the end. And then you can also add a custom disclaimer, but we won't get into this now, into the details. Adding a link where people are being redirected to when they submit the form, and then you simply create that form. This is for testing purposes only, so we know that the connection is working, and then we can map it to our CRM system. Now, the second thing you need is the so-called lead ads testing tool, which is this one. I will also put a link to this tool in the description below. And here, select your page that you just set up the form for. Then the test form should already be available. You can click on preview the form or create lead. If you create the lead, it will just use random replies and not answer your custom questions. If you use preview form, you can actually fill out the questions customized with your details. I will do that for now. Okay, so what is your favorite fruit? Apple, email, just a test email, full name, manual, gig, and then press next, submit. And now that lead gets submitted to our API. You can see your test lead has been sent. To create a new lead, please delete this one. And if we go back into make, we can see there's actually one at the top right. So that means, hey, we actually got something submitted here, but it looks super weird. We can't read anything. We don't have an email address. So how do we get this out now? We need an additional module, which is called the Get Lead Details module. You simply map it here, and then we can select all details from our form module here. So the page ID, the form ID, and the lead ID. You can map it completely, so it's fully dynamic. No matter what you connect to this module, it will work. And you can also just duplicate this scenario for other pages later on. And now let's look at what comes out if we do it this way. So let it run one more time. And creating the lead does not work anymore. So you have to delete the lead first, and then you can create a new lead. And then going back into our scenario, it will send a lead here again. And now we are getting the actual data out. So the what is your favorite fruit? And here's just test lead dummy data for it, then email test and full name test. This is just dummy data. If we preview the form again, like using this one over here, and actually fill in our details, then we will also get other responses out. But the data is now good for actually mapping. So in our CRM system, it just has name, email, and then we can also add favorite fruit. And then back to our CRM system. So opening that one and refreshing the column headers that we have. So this is all pre-filled because we already put the spreadsheet ID here. Just adding a row. It's a regular Google Sheet add a row module. And then we can map the name, the full name, the email address, and the favorite fruit response here into our CRM system, and also connect it to our autoresponder or wherever we need it. So now let's try this out, try the full thing, deleting the lead again, then creating a new lead, and checking our Google Sheet if it appears here. And here we go. So we have the test lead dummy data for the full name, the email address, and the test lead dummy data for the favorite fruit. This is bold because the first row was bold and it takes the format of the previous row. So from now on, everything will not be bold anymore. And let's test it one last time with actual data in the form so we know it actually works properly. So let's run this one more time. Preview form, and then say Apple here, test, and my name, next, submit. And now let's check our Google Sheet, what if it fills the data. And here we go. So it works instantly. It works anytime a new lead comes in and you got your data right away in your CRM system. I hope this helped and you learned how you can connect your Facebook lead ads, how you can integrate your Facebook leads to your CRM system. And from now on, this will be fully automated. If you want to get more videos like this, please like this video and subscribe to our channel. We are going to output a lot more tutorials moving forward, so make sure you're not missing any of these tutorials. If you have any questions or have a specific request, put it in the comments below this video and we are going to reply to you as fast as possible. Thank you very much for watching.